So now that we have our script, our setup script confined as well, for now only for root, and root should of course not run the script in a confined domain, because unconfined T should not run the script in the confined domain, because that's an oxymoron. But that we at least know what the script needs. So now we're going to work on a role, a privileged role that's basically allowed to create new instances and assign categories and assign privileges to these instances. We have very limited functionality now. We only have this basically two kind of instances, a basic instance and an instance that can run ping, but that at least gives you the idea of the possibilities, and basically then allow that administrator to basically like create these instances and run these instances and stuff like that. And we want to do that in a way so that you can only manage that stuff, and you cannot use that to basically compromise the system. So ls or pwd, we're at varlib, my one-shot setup, and I'm going to just create that module in this directory, because it's going to depend on it a little bit. We're going to basically hook into it a little, or actually let's just add that in the same module. Let's just put it all in the same damn module. So we're just going to create a new section. And it's called one shot admin, my one shot admin. So user DOM base user template. This is a template that creates a base user. And the base user is not a login user, so he doesn't have access to his home directory, to a home directory. Should be just the bare minimums to be a user, and hopefully that works in Fedora 19. I haven't actually tested that. So we're going to call this my one shot admin. Now there's a couple of things we need to take care of, or a couple of things. Basically one thing we need to, we're going to set this up like the following. First of all, we're going to create a user and then allow that user to log in as a staff user, and a staff user is allowed to run sudo, and he can then, we're going to restrict him so that we can allow him to go from the staff domain or the staff role to the my one-shot admin role, so he can actually use sudo to switch to a new role that allows him to manage the my one-shot stuff. So we need to basically require the staff role staff. So this basically makes it depend on the staff module, but yeah, that's always there, so we don't have to basically make that conditional optional, because staff is almost always there. If you remove that, then I don't support it anyways. So then we need to allow the staff role access to our new created my one shot admin role, and that role is created by the user DOM base user template. And this basically allows staff to change to the my one-shot admin role. Now, that basically means that we also now have types to transition. So we're going to change some stuff here. So this is a hack that allows unconfined, and we're going to remove the unconfined support here now. That allows unconfined role access to my one-shot setup. And now we're going to make it so that my one-shot admin role has access to that my one-shot setup type. And then we are going to allow my one-shot admin to allow that script. And then this is only needed, probably only needed and if it's not, then we'll figure that out. So we can remove that. Let's just also move this below where these rules are. All right. So that's that, and then this should be suffice. And that's basically, now we got rid of all the unconfined stuff, I think. Now, but what we're also going to do is we're going to create some new attributes here as well. So we're going to create a one-shot domain attribute. My one-shot domain. And do we need anything else? No, not. Yeah. Oh, no. Sorry. That's it. So my one-shot domain is done there. Let's go to the interface file and assign that my one-shot domain also to my one-shot domain. Also assign that to this mother here, my one shot domain. Okie dokie. Now that seems okay. Now what we're going to do is basically create a my one shot admin that basically allows the guy to administrate one shot. So I'm just going to borrow this from the repository. We'll use Apache. Interface file and Apache admin should be somewhere in here. Yeah, here it is. So first of all, just copy this, and our admin is different though, because we don't need a role here. But it is a role capability. I call it my one shot admin. Now close that here, and then just add some of these rules in there, and I'll just also make this a bit more sane. Okay, then my one shot. Alright, now let's just have a look at that and see. This is not it. What's in there? Now we're going to require some types, some attributes actually. The same attributes as we require, much of the same attributes that we required, and the types. Probably not needed. So that's basically it. Now we want this user to be able to send some signals to the process, to the to the processes and PSM and stuff like that, and PTrace. Let's just copy this over and just add that in. But instead of a type, we're going to use an attribute. So we are allowing our user to signal and ptrace my one-shot domain. And then we're going to allow the same for PS process pattern. So basically PS the my one shot domains. So every type that is classified in my one shot domain. And then we have here this stuff, but we don't need this here. We don't need that, as far as I know, but we do need some of this stuff here. So yeah, do we want to allow this user to actually edit the unit files? We could do that. Although probably it might not be a good idea, so for you consider for yourself whether you would like that. Actually I'm not going to allow this myself. That basically I'm just basically the only way for him to manage the unit files is to basically by using the script, the my one shot setup script. And then there's this Apache system control thingy. And I should look that up, see what's that in there. Apache system control. Oh, you need to actually read. Let's just add that in. So he can read it, but he can't manage it. And then he needs to be able to run systemd system control. That might actually just be enough. Well, not quite. So let's just also allow him to manage the contents, the data. So yeah, that's basically it. Let's see where that gets us. And then basically allow our admin to administrate. And it only expects a single parameter. Now, as for putting my one-shot setup process, we might want to allow it to actually allow because if it for some reason gets stuck, we should probably be able to kill it and to send sick or hip it or I don't know what else. And he should probably be able to list it, PS it. Might be a good idea, it's not something that should be a big problem. So yeah, that should basically theoretically set this whole thing up, but there's probably going to be many issues. Let's just make it. And I have a on line 143 and end of file and argument list. And it's probably here in somewhere here. Yeah. Build, load that into the system. And then basically create a new user. So it's basically user add. And I call this my one shot admin. My one shot admin. Alright, so that user is added. Let's just create a new selinux user. And we need full access, by the way, to categories, else the user won't be able to manage the data content. Because the data content is restricted. And actually, might actually be not be the case. Let's just try that out. Though, it's gonna make stuff complex, more complex. Staff role and the my, what's called my one shot admin. And then prefix is user, and then my one shot admin underscore u is the name of the selinux user mapping. So he doesn't have access to categories, so he might actually be prevented access to data, but we'll just have a look, because I'm not sure if it makes any difference if he's not MCS constrained. Probably he'd probably be allowed at access, not sure, but he might just be. So as you manage login, add, and then s my one shot admin u, and then range f0, then my one shot admin, my one shot admin. Yeah, this will map the selinux user to the Linux user. Alright, let's see if he has access nano, etc, activity. Does it, oh, 1-shot admin. My 1-shot admin. So he does have actually network access. And then echo my 1-shot admin. Oh, actually. Third is all actually root, and then type is my 1-shot admin. D role is my 1-shot admin role, and then all, and then just etc sudoers the my 1-shot admin. Let's have a look, see if that looks okay. Seems okay. Tmod 0440. Next, you need to cp etc as in Linux targeted contexts users, and then staff u, and then etc as in Linux targeted contexts users, and then my 1-shot admin u. CP is that, yeah, that's a CP. And then just edit that a little bit, because this user is only allowed to log in via SSH. I want him to only be able to log in via SSH, so I'm going to remove some stuff, and he doesn't have access to sysadmin, so no need to do that. It doesn't use su, but he does use sudo. This is not needed, this is needed, and these two aren't needed, so this should theoretically take care of that. Open a new shell and SSH my 1-shot admin at SSH net kb info. We need to basically take care of lslc home my 1-shot admin. I'll just need the top one. And then with this, it's, well, let's have a look at that. It's what, 600, and the parents, I don't even see the parent. It's 500 and 700, I guess. Actually, yeah. So, tmod 0440. Actually, not it. Get 600. Yeah. And this is 700. Seems okay. Now town, and then my one shot admin, my one shot admin, and then home, my one shot admin SSH. That looks okay, I guess. Try that again. Damn it. Not allowed to log in. Why is that? Tail var log secure invalid user. I'll be goddamned. Groups. Dominic. Let's see, because I might have some. Yeah, I have some stupid groups. Group one. So user mod A. G group 1 and SSH users, and then my one shot admin. I'll try that again. ID. Snam stuff as one, my one shot admin U. So sudo shell. ID. Now I'm my one shot admin. So does that mean I can go to serve my one shot? Serve my one shot. Can I actually get my one shot text? I can. Can I actually modify it? Oh, actually, that makes sense, because that's actually not MCS constrained. So Yeah, I can modify that. That's pretty obvious, because I'll show you that. You see, because I am my one-shot admin. Now, let's just cut user has been my one-shot setup. So I can read it. Let's just see if I can nano it, if I can edit it. Nano. And you see it's no write permission. And I'm root. But I just don't have the permissions to write. And the same goes for nano etc system, the system, and then my one shot service. See, no write permission. I could give him that write permission, but I don't really need to, because the script sets up this file. So I don't see any real need for that. PS aux. I can't CD process, because I don't have access to kernel read system state, I think it is. So I could edit that. Nano, my one shot admin. I could edit that kernel read system state. I think someone told me that that's actually makes it work. Kernel read system state. Although it doesn't really make sense, because stuff can do it. But oh well. So let's just see if my one-shot admin can actually start a service and stuff like that. System control start my one-shot. And it's 15:30. Seems to have worked, so let's just so I was actually able to start that in the right domain. Let's see if there's any AVC denials with regard to that. I still have don't audits on. There is some stuff in here. But this is basically relay. This should be don't audited, so we can ignore this stuff here. So we able to start the service. Now let's see if we can do a PS aux. So now basically we can actually see some stuff. At least we can see our own processes, and then we can also we would also be able to see the process of the scripts and of the services of the instances. Now I'm pretty sure that the script will not work in enforcer mode. Just call it intuition. call it intuition. So what I'm going to do is set and force 0. And just see if it runs. It runs in permissive mode, but at least it should. See if there's any ABC denials, any strange things going on. Doesn't seem to be any. At least not in the first. On the first notice. Except the deck override. That's because I'm in my home in someone else's home directory, so I need to probably need to add that as well. And that's fine because I need to edit it anyways. So my one shot admin, allow that, and then remove some stuff here that was added. And then also RM RF serve test 1 and RM etc system D system, and then test 1 service. Yes, now set and force 1. I'll search MACTS 1534. And it's clean. And let's just try that again. In enforcing mode. Let's see what ABC denials we've gotten. We have a deck research. And we probably only need deck research. We can probably don't audit the deck override. Because this is basically just for traversal. So can probably don't audit deck override. Okay, so that's oh, actually I need to remove that stuff here again. So now we have it guess. So now we have our confined admin. get and force as a module B to hide ABC denials that aren't related. Let's see, info xt my one shot admin t. See, it's pretty much he has pretty many permissions. Etc as a Linux targeted. Let's see if there's any policy. The policy is now probably created by the user. No, actually not. Uncle find you. That's weird. Oh yeah, that's because the last time I did that, I guess. Nothing. That's weird. That's probably because of that SE module DB. Anyways, let's see, one shot setup. That looks okay. I'll search MABCTS recent. Is 35, just old stuff. So I'll make that 15.39. Audit to allow. Okay, and I just basically log off. Just act like we're just a admin. So clear that. So basically, we're logging in. We're admin. We're ID. We're staff. But we could basically make this guest as well, a modified guest, so that the user doesn't have so much permission. Because now it's as staff, he has a lot of permissions. See, he can actually list the whole system, which isn't a good idea. But I just, to make this a simple example, I just decided to do that. So, and then basically, if he wants to do something, so like for example, list sudo ps aux. Now he actually has very little permissions to see, so it's actually stupid because the default domain has more permissions with regard to PS than the root domain actually. But anyway, so so basically sudo, for example, you some guy would probably want to or might want to ls alt var lib my one shot admin setup. Oh, my one shot set. But permission is denied because that's there's where the policy files are. So I wouldn't want this admin to actually be able to modify the policy file that is hard coded into the scripts to be compiled, so that he can basically add some rules, for example, make himself unconfined admin. Or I wouldn't want him to restore. See, restore the context or whatever. Because yeah, they're probably going to try to find a way to to abuse a system. For example, they'll try to nano user adsbin. See to edit the script so that they can basically add some policy here to change the behavior. For example, make himself a unconfined user by editing this file, but he can't edit it. So that's no problem. And the same goes for the files in etc. System, the system, and then my one shot service. See, you can't edit it, but you really should be very careful with this stuff, because he does actually have some permissions, this admin, but it shouldn't be anything harmful. But always make sure that you know exactly what permissions you give. So use the SESearch command and the SEInfo command to really check it out, what the stuff is. So let's just create a few. So I'll just find that here. What I used probably a long time ago. Yeah, because he isn't able to save his history. That's also a nice feature. I guess. He isn't able to save his history because he's not allowed to write to the bash history file of root. So that's pretty cool. So you don't have to worry about hackers trying to look at this admin's history, because that's not going to happen. So yeah, let's just set this up. And that's not going to happen. Not, at least not without sudo. But it is going to happen with sudo. So yeah, it's actually now adding a new one. And it sets it up. Takes a little while. Though this should by now be done. I think we have some issue here. Probably file descriptor issue. Oh, we have a child terminated signal. So yeah, that's missing policy. Crying out loud. So yeah, that sucks. Need to add that to the policy. Related to stuff. Yeah, it can't kill itself because it's can't send a child, it can't terminate itself because it can't send a child terminated signal. So I'm gonna need to kill it. I'm going to need to kill it. PS aux. What's this defunct? So we need to basically kill this one here. If this will happen, I have another issue. Let's just do that instead of voice mode. So that's funny. To me, it is. Still not happening. Let me see that process running in the right domain though. Oh, it's actually the wrong one. But still not allowed to do it. Well, I'll be damned. Why am I not allowed to do that? Now I'm done. But now, okay, now I'm out of my shell. Now I can, for example, do another one. This should now work, hopefully. Oh, and I should make one without ping though. See if that works as well. So now we have a test one, test two, and test three. So system and get in force. System control start test three. And we have an access denied. Well, I'll be damned. At 50, I guess. Nothing to do. As a module, DB. Might be related to MCS. Not sure. try that again. That's weird. Am I doing something wrong? Oh, sure I do. Jesus. We're in enforcement mode, aren't we? Get enforce. Yeah. So, serve. Let's see if we can access this stuff. Serve, and then it's test 3. Text. It can't access it. Now this is due to MCS, and I was basically already see data there read search, and this is MCS. Here you have it. This is it. So basically, oh, actually that's stupid. I keep doing that. That's so stupid. You need to use sudo. So that wasn't the issue, and let's see if we can actually nano it. Yeah, I can actually nano it. So now you have yourself a confined administrator, and let's see if it's sudo system control. ISCD restart, access denied, and then let's have a look at that. If it probably doesn't audit it. Doesn't audit it. Seem to be password agent. Let's see, 55, so. That's audited somewhere else. Here it is. So here you have it. As a my one-shot admin to restart the NGIRCD daemon. So restart NGIRCD. So it was allowed or was denied access to do that on the generic system unit file. Ships. That shouldn't be generic anyways. But it does show. No, I need to fix that because that shouldn't be a generic file in my view. But anyway, so it's nice. You cannot start any other services. So yeah, this is basically the whole idea from a confined administrator to a confined script that creates confined instances of a single executable file, and then uses MCS to do the isolation, uses type enforcement to actually limit the domains. So if I have a look now, nano my one shot TE, you have these three domains where the last domain doesn't have the ping option. So if test 3 would run with ping, then he would get access denied for actually for the ping permissions. Whereas instance 2 and 1 actually are both allowed to run ping. Those all have the same permissions from a type enforcement perspective, but are isolated. So instance 1 cannot fuck with instance 2, and instance 2 cannot fuck with instance 1 and instance 3, by the way, also, because they're all MCS restricted. But you could basically do two instances with the same category, and that way they will be able to fuck with each other, I guess, in theory. In practice, actually. So that's actually pretty neat. And so it's a pretty automated environment where you basically, it's just running a script and it's all set up for you, and you have your script confined, so the admin cannot mess with the script. He can only read it and execute it with a domain transition and stuff may be able to execute it, but if he's even able to execute it, stuff, and actually I tried that accidentally, then it won't work anyways because he doesn't have the permissions to do it. And well, the my one-shot admin is basically you can just only execute that my one-shot setup executable file, and then he can read system state, and he can search his current PWD. This is for his current PWD. So if you're basically logging in a stuff and then run sudo, then you're probably in your home directory, and so the program that you run at that point needs to get its current PWD, which is then at that point home my one shot admin, which is not owned by root. And so the my one shot setup, which is run by root, which is root, needs to be able to needs these permissions to be able to basically get the current PWD. And then my one shot admin can actually ptrace and signal the my one shot setup process. So what you could see previously, where I forgot to add this rule here, so that setup can send a child terminated signal to sudo. I could basically just log in another time in a different session with the my one shot admin, and then just use that session to kill the other process. I did that as unconfined T in previously, but you could do that the same way by just logging in again as my one shot admin, and then the sudo, and then kill, and then the PID, and it can also PS the processes and stuff. And basically stuff can change to my one shot admin. You might want to basically not use stuff, but basically clone the guest role, or even create your own role from scratch, which only has the permissions you need. I did that in previous examples, which you can find probably on YouTube. But I just chose stuff in this example because it's the most easiest way, because stuff has access to sudo already. So that was the quickest example. And then the my one shot admin, which you can find the API, which you can find in the my one shot interface file, which basically allows the admin, the one who calls it, the my one shot admin, to manage the services. And then here you have these instances which are created by the script, which is this stuff here. So yeah, this is actually pretty cool, although it's useless because it doesn't really make sense, the whole thing. But if you can translate this to something practical, like for example HTTPD services, different services, and you can actually translate it like that, then you can basically create a pretty restricted admin that can actually create different instances and manage them. So that's pretty neat indeed. Although I have to tell you that this script doesn't have any sanity checking, so you really, 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 really want to do sanity checking, because else this script might just used to abuse. So yeah, make sure you, if you implement this, that you make that script, setup script, that you make that solid and not like I did, because I can basically screw up the system probably by just entering some stupid option, and then the whole thing crashes probably. Anyways, so yeah, that's probably all I should show you. It's the whole thing.